Blake thinks that it's totally implausible.
Well, maybe he's right.
You don't really believe that.
Well, of course I'd like to know whether I lost my job because we were onto something or because I'd become a pain in the butt.
Then let's find out.
How?
Well, the easiest way would be to get the research data back.
The data's backed up on my computer, it's got to be.
Is it?
But they took my security card back when they fired me.
Is there anyone there who might be sympathetic to our cause?
Well, the closest thing I've got to a man at head office is John Markson, but I'd hardly call him sympathetic.
Still, he might be useful, though.
We'll give him another couple of minutes.
Sorry, mate.
That's fine. As soon as you've got your breath back, I'd like to start with your account first.
Sure. During the first stage of the procedure, Dr. Warner successfully dissected the esophagus to expose the tumour. At this point, we realised that it had invaded the pericardium more extensively than initially thought. I believed it inadvisable to continue, given the added complexity of the surgery, but Dr. Warner was keen to proceed. I did question this with him, but was overruled. During the final stage of the surgery, as the tumour was being removed, there was an extensive bleed which we were unable to contain. The patient began exhibiting symptoms of hypervolemia, and despite aggressive treatment, he went into cardiac arrest and did not respond to CPR.
Thank you.
Can I also just say that I was opposed to the surgery from the start and had made this very clear to Dr. Warner.
Brenda, have you anything else to add?
I had misgivings about the wisdom of Dr. Warner's decision at the time, but I also had great faith in his abilities. As I chose not to say anything at the time, as a result, I have to stand by that decision now.
Chris?
In any circumstances, a transitional esophagectomy is a risky and difficult procedure. However, there are a number of factors in determining level of risk. The health of the patient, the skill of the surgeon, the competency of the team. I believe, all this considered, I made a reasonable call in electing to proceed with the surgery. And once underway, I did everything I could to ensure the best outcome for that patient. I agree the procedure may be regarded as radical by some, but surgeons of my skill have a certain obligation to extend the boundaries of what is possible at times. That's how the field of medicine progresses.
So Barry Walters was just an experiment gone wrong?
Mr. Walters was fully informed and readily consented to the procedure.
Wouldn't say readily.
Look, I'm not trying to make light of the fact that a man died, but everyone in this room knows that is a reality of our job.
So, have you got something lined up?
No, so if you hear any jobs going elsewhere,
I'll keep an ear to the ground.
Thanks. Actually, I was hoping you might act as a referee for me. I can't imagine Scott Speer giving me a reference I can use. Look, I know you think I've been a fool over the MIAC trial, but I'm asking as a mate.
Go on, then.
I owe you.
Hey, look, there's Sarah. You met her the other day, remember?
Hi, Ed. And, John?
I thought this was my exclusive little haunt.
Oh, well, I love the cakes here. I can't decide on the brownie or the lemon tart. They're both to die for.
Well, I was just about to suggest dessert. Fancy joining us?
Oh, thank you very much. There's nothing worse than eating cake on your own. It looks so piggy. You have got to try the brownie.
I have, and I was planning on having it again.
Well, then I will have the lemon tart, and that way I can pinch it on yours.
Right, well, you stay there, and I'll get the order.
Thanks.
Fancy checking out the spread?
I might pass. Not much of a sweet tooth.
Well, this stuff will change your mind.
No, thanks.
Except if you try the raspberry friand, which also happens to be one of my favourites.
For you, then.
You will love it, and I promise to steal just a tiny, tiny bit. So what happens now?
Well, that's up to Huya. Obviously, I hope it ends here. Even if I'm not entirely sure it should.
Wash your mouth out. Looking for me?
I've made an admin error. I'm actually two beds short on the unit. Is there any chance to overflow into medical?
There's no spare beds for Chocker.
I'm sorry, I just don't know where my brain is.
And you want sympathy?
No.
Good, because you're not exactly tolerant of other people's mistakes. Sorry, that wasn't fair. You did what you felt was right.
Clearly, you don't think it was.
I wasn't in theatre, I don't know the case.
No, you don't.
But making a formal complaint is a serious deal. Chris is devastated.
Well, I'm sorry, but he's not the victim.
I just wonder if you reacted the way you have because you're under stress yourself.
Excuse me?
This has been a difficult time for you.
I'm working through it.
Yes, but a lot of that is happening right here, which isn't good for anyone.
You think I'm not coping?
I'm trying to suggest that a better place to work through your problems is at home.
You want me to take time off?
I'm not being vengeful. I'm just concerned.
I'll think about it.
Okay. I'll find those two beds for you.
So do you have time for another coffee?
Sadly, I have to get going.
My shout.
Are you sure?
Absolutely. And if he doesn't, I will.
Oh, thank you. It was nice seeing you again.
Share my cake with you anytime. You'll be sad to lose the pleasure of working with her.
Yeah, she's great.
Isn't she just? Well, I'll get it.
No, you won't. This is by way of a thank you.
If you insist.
Cheers.
Wasn't easy on Mark. He thought long and hard about it.
Yeah, I know he did. Poor bugger.
None of us like to be in that position. Or yours.
Right now, I'd gladly swap.
Yeah, I believe the op was pretty messy.
Excuse me, Dr. Warner. This just arrived for you by courier.
Oh, thank you. Not too shoddy either.
It's from Clive Stratton.
You and his brilliant career and his sense of whiskey. Welcome to the club, Warner. How does it feel, Clive?